What's up, everybody? Day 248, making song bringer. Today I'm gonna be drawing some enemies. So the other day I was making all these new behaviors, and then yesterday I was fixing the behaviors and making them all better. And today I'm actually gonna finally draw these enemies. So four different enemies. I don't know if I can actually draw four enemies in one stream, but we'll see. I'll try. First I'm gonna start with these guys. These are like diagonal bouncer guys. They just bounce. That's all they do. Real stupid enemies. But yeah, meant for more easy areas. So I'm thinking these guys are going to be kind of an easy thing to draw would be a hovering ball. And I think that would work well for a diagonal bouncing stupid enemy. So I'm thinking that's what we're going to draw, just some balls that bounce around. Maybe like marbles that roll around even. Yeah, maybe rolling marbles. That might be hard to draw. I don't know. We'll do floating marbles for now. Okay, so yeah, let's start drawing that. First, we should dial in some proportions. Get my game tablet out. Graphics tablet. Probably something like 24, 32 max. Okay, and let's start with just a circle shape. Just to dial in proportions, let's see how big this should be. The player has a width of like, how big is the player? Nine or so. Yeah, this is gonna be way too wide. That might do about 10 pixels. So yeah, something like that. Let's see if that's centered. That's 12. That's 12. That works. Okay. Just draw a little bit. I like that hue compared to this one. First, let's start with maybe messing with this hue. This hue is too saturated. Now it's too light. What's up, Bit of Barney? Yo, man, welcome to the stream. How's it going today? I don't know, maybe this saturation level will work. Let's try it out. Besides, gun dines, proportions. I don't know what to call this guy yet either. What are we going to call this guy? This guy's bouncing. He bounces around the screen diagonally, floats in the air. don't know. We'll call him a Biag for now. Biag. Biag? Biag. Biag. Sure, whatever. Biag it is. Foes. However the hell you spell it. Am I going to remember how to spell that? Hopefully. Save this first frame out and check if it's the right size. Right proportion, right height off the ground. Alright, now these guys are going to be called Biags from now on. And we need to put it in the foes. What's up, Arcane? Welcome, welcome. How you doing today? Four of them? Yes. Four will do. I think we should be able to... Oh, wait. First of all... You change this guy's art. Biag zero for now. Alright. So we'll see if this is the right size, right saturation, right hue. And we'll work on him a little bit more. What's up? Custom shell script? You just crashing? What's going on, man? Oh, there it goes again. Building the common sheet takes way too long. I don't know what's up with that. Texture Packer's having a hard time with this. 2048 by 2048, huh? That sheet might be too big now. Well, they didn't change. Why isn't your art different? What happened there? So I just changed the name of that sequence there to see if it's actually running that. This guy's AI. Heading. Bounce with one E. Bounce two, bounce. Okay, something happened. That's not right. What's up, Pedro? How you doing, man? Oh. Infinite buffering? Oh no. Ah, so what's going on is inside the products folder needs to be rebuilt because it still has that double A. But that, shouldn't it be loading the Biag? Oh yeah, here's the problem. No, it's not, that should be fine. Unless we're at, okay. So what position? 12-4-0. Double A. Oh, here it is. There. So the middle guy needed to be changed, not that guy. All right. Come on, work this time. Oh, man, what the hell? So these guys are patrolling again all of a sudden. Patrolling would be this first guy. Man, this is... I don't know what the hell's going on. I think it might have been that. There they are. The Bob Ross stream. Oh no. You can see now? Nice. No more buffering? Stupid buffering. So I'm dialing into which enemy we're freaking working on here. Is Twitch dead? What the hell? Is it working now? It's extra twitchy today. It did? Nice. Right on. Congrats, man. Sounds like progress. So what to do with these guys? What to make them look like? I mean, that's all right with this whole red thing. I guess they should hover first. Let's make them hover a little bit. I guess they kind of look okay like that. But it's so simple, I feel like I'm cheating as an artist. All right, so let's update the art. Damn, there it goes. Recompiling this sprite sheet, taking forever. This is really slowing it down. To say that it's annoying would be an understatement. It's like never happened before until one little threshold happened and all of a sudden this sprite sheet takes forever to build. If I change any tiny little bit of art, it all does this. Maybe I need to update Texture Packer. Wow, now they look kind of happy. They're bouncy. I almost think these things are so—they're so unintelligent, right? All they do is just bounce, 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 bounce. They don't really detect you. They don't really care about you. It's almost like they should be—they shouldn't have any eyes. Like whatever kind of creature or entity they are, they shouldn't have eyes. Tempted to just leave them how they are. Maybe if they had some kind of aura field or glow. Let's see what that would look like. What's up, blood? This looks okay. Here we go. Rebuilding again. Man. Oh, that time it worked? Check it out. That time it was fast as hell. What's up with that? All right, that is definitely a crazy effect, right? It almost makes it look like they have mouths, plural. A mouth on all of them. But if I kept that to one. All right, man. If this was like that. That might work. Let's see. What about maybe they should have a pink? Nah, see, I don't want to really have eyes. But would one tiny little hole or like glowing light? Let's see if that, what would that look like? If this had tiny glowing light type thing here. Let's get a pink color. It's nice there, about like that. Very glowing, like very bright. It's a weird effect. I don't know why it works so well, but it does. What if this pink light was in the middle here? Sometimes Texture Packer takes forever. Sometimes Texture Packer does not take forever. Wait a minute. You know what? Maybe I should take out a few. Oh, yeah. We should try and solve this problem right now. Because this is getting really, really annoying. This is going to slow down the whole stream. Not that you guys can even watch the stream right now. Thanks to... I'm going to go ahead and blame Twitch. Yeah, it's got to be Twitch's fault. But yeah, so hell, might as well fix this, right? This is annoying me enough to do something about it. I think if I rearrange this sprite sheet, put some other big frames in some other sprite sheet, this might really, really help. Okay, now it's done building. I can go into Texture Packer. Let's see what that one little render turned out to be look like. Oh man, that those two pixels on the top really gave him almost like a horn-like look. I like them. I kind of like these little guys. I don't know what they are, but I like them. Alright, yeah, that'll do. We'll draw some kind of death animation for them next, and then they'll be done. Wow. Wow, man. Wow. Okay. Texture Packer. What the hell, Texture Packer? Oh man, dude. Texture pack. Calculating layout for assets. Here's the problem. There's so many assets in here. It's like, I can't figure it out. Or either that, or maybe it's using an algorithm that's super slow. This should never happen. This is why this is taking so long. Hitbox. Yeah, hitbox. Yeah, right. It's days like this where it's tempting to switch over. There we go. It finally calculated the layout. And then, yeah, okay. So what if we change it's the layout algorithm? That's 4 squared. Wait. Oh, I can't. Should be no scaling variance. Still buffering, dude. Oh man, it's almost not even worth streaming today. What's up, Twitch? I think I'm okay. There's max rex or basic, and then there's heuristics. Yeah, maybe this might have a lot to do with it too. Heuristics, pack, good. Pack good. Area fit. See, it's working. Yay, dude. If you're here and you can see the stream, I'm gonna keep on streaming. That's all that matters. Okay, if I turn that back to best. There. Okay, I'm gonna save this. I'm gonna reopen Texture Packer because this shit like loves to slow down. So let's see if it's fixed now. Trying to deal with this simple little problem so I don't have to wait so long. Okay, what, calculating layout? Still taking for, oh, there. It wasn't that bad that time. I think we have a solution. I did 4 squared. The pack, I just did good instead of best. Hell, maybe I should just do fast. Yeah. I mean, I knew you were here the whole time. I'm just saying. Yeah, pack fast, man. Don't worry about packing perfect. Okay, let's hope that fixed it. Don't think it changed the sprite sheet at all. Okay, so here's what we got for a visual look for these guys so far. They look kind of almost like they remind me of Pac-Man. Little red blobs that just float around. They almost look like they have horns. They're dumb. They're very dumb. That works. They're a color. It's distinct. They're simple. Okay, let's draw something where they explode or die or something. So we'll save this one. Call this the Biag Death. Die. Release. Release. Okay, so when these things die, I'm thinking it'd be cool if it looked like they got slashed in half. They hang in the air for a second and then just go and fall apart. Maybe they even have some sparks or something like that when they get that whole slashed in half thing going on. Okay, so let's get that slashed in half look started. So Bob Ross has his own stream? For real? Bob Ross. That's awesome. That's so awesome. Bob Ross, you're awesome. Still kicking it. Oh, really? Okay, so it's the official launching of the creative category. I saw someone else doing creative today. Is that what do you think about that, Pedro? What do you think about the creative category? Tell me more about it too. I'm kind of unaware of stuff. You probably learned by now. All right, now let's get a. Wow, yeah, actually, let's get this thing to spark and look sweet. Yeah, we'll do a bright layer on top of this. Some like yellow, sparky energy. Some I'm like creating some sparky energy going on here for this background for this one frame where he just gets sliced in half, sparks fly, and then he falls in half. Oh, yeah. Huh. Is it worth, should I start doing creative as my category or what? Should I just keep it how it is? Game development? Right, so there's that frame. It's sliced. Sparks. Let's do frame two of the sparks. Less of them. Wait, I just messed it up. I need these separate there. All right. All right, here we got two frames of sparks. Next, we'll do them falling to the ground in two pieces. I kind of want them to hang in the air like this, so this is going to be fun to play with. So right here's where he's kind of hanging in the air. All right, next one. All right, so this is really easy to do, that hanging in the air thing. The next one thing is where he'll fall to the ground and kind of like turn, in the, I guess, a little bit in the air, maybe. Actually, no, he doesn't really need to turn in the air. He can turn when he hits the ground. Yeah, which remind me who this guy was. I played Diablo many, many hours, but which one was the treasure goblin? Let me see if I can find the... What did this guy look like? Oh, yeah, did he steal stuff from you? Is that who he was? Or is this a new Diablo guy? Oh, yeah, I don't know if you guys seen this guy. I haven't played Diablo 3. This is Diablo 3, right? He only runs away from you and drops coins when you hit him. Ah. Oh, they're ultra rare, so you like win a lot of gold if you find one. That's kind of cool. I love these ultra rare enemies. It's neat. I like that. Good idea. That's a cool idea for a enemy. That does look like a lot of gold. Have you played Diablo 3? I mean, of course you have, if you're mentioning this guy. How is Diablo 3? Ah. Bicubic filtering nearest neighbor. Always nearest neighbor. Yeah, you like it? Nice, nice, nice. I gotta play it then. That and StarCraft 2. I haven't played either of those. Am I just like the worst gamer ever? What's up, TM? Nice. Oh, glad you can. So I'm drawing this guy here. Let me show you. I'll show you in a sec. Ooh. Oh, nice. Yeah, I like that. Those whole rare enemies that have something really special, unique to them. So there are these guys. These are the diagonal guys, right? You were here when I was doing the behaviors for these guys. And I am gonna do a reflect version of their the AI. So instead of when it would, if it was going diagonally this way, it would hit this wall and bounce off that way, you know. So yeah, that's something I've added to the AI system. I just haven't finished. But yeah, I'm just drawing them right now. I'm drawing in a little explode for them. Definitely looking for some feedback. I'm not sure if these are cool enough yet, but you know what? Is anything ever really that cool when I first created? Not really. It gets better and better. I'm an iterative artist. I'm an iterative programmer. All of it iterative. Let's get at least one more frame. This is his dying animation, by the way. Sweet. Why does the bottom flicker? I added an effect that made it do that. Because it almost made him look like he had his teeth and his mouth was chomping and stuff. Let me see if we're talking about the same flicker though. Let me run it again. Yeah. Yeah, I kind of did that to make him look like he's biting or something like that. But let me know if it looks bad. Like a bad kind of flicker. All right, yeah, let's try this out. Okay. All right. Okay, I think we're ready to try this. Let's put this animation together and see how it looks. Starts there. We don't need to start with that frame. We start actually with this frame. Actually, yeah, we'll start with that frame. And then delete it before it's exported. So it goes like that. There's this bright sparkiness. Hangs there for a second. Yeah, need more pixels, right? Story of my life with this video game. Yeah. Be nice to have more pixels, but it's also nice to have the challenge of what can I do with this few amount of pixels, you know? It's actually has led to some really crazy cool things. And it's almost a testament to what the eye can see without there really being that much to see. You know, so few pixels, it leaves more to the imagination. And that's really how the mind, it's our, you know, our eyes take what visual information we see and then interpret, our brain interprets it. So, you know, a lot of art is that in that interpretation. So that's why pixel art works. Right, and let's add a little hang on the end just to see what it would look like in the animation. Actually, maybe it would be cool if he had the light slashing through the middle of him right in the very beginning here. Let's try that. Oh, propagate frame one. Ugh. Sweet, glad it looks good. Yeah, I think it would look even better with this one more frame. So I'm gonna draw a slash through the middle here. Right, so this is actually what this is what they would look like in the game with this first frame like that. So let's try that again. Yeah, I like it. Okay, let's put it in. It's always nice to put in a nice, satisfying animation like this. You know, when you kill an enemy, it's like it better be satisfying. Save. Export render video. These guys are called the Bayag. I never know what to name enemies, so if anybody ever has any suggestions, please. Please help. Bayag. Alright, so now he's got a release animation. Can hook that up in the profile. Bayag release. And does it take a long time for the shell script? Yes? No. Good. Oh, thank God. Texture Packer was using this crazy algorithm and it was taking forever. But not anymore. I couldn't see it. Jib, you're in the way. It's all your fault. Well, that is neat. I like it. I like that it hangs there for a second. That's kind of cool. But I think it should be a little faster, so let's give this thing a smaller delay. A little bit smaller. So no, typical delay is a tenth of a second. Let's give that maybe, let's try 7.5. And then we'll start another enemy. Start drawing another one of these guys. Maybe we got the patrols or something. Yeah, that was a little better. Yeah, I like it. Cool. Yeah, that guy's done. Yeah, right on. Okay, next guy. All right, so we've got those four different enemies. There's one guy that patrols. There's a guy that shoots diagonal projectiles. I think, oh, this guy's pretty simple. And then there's the guy that walks around and around and around, hugs an edge. Which one next? So the guy that hugs stuff, I was thinking he might kind of look like an anteater, sort of. And then the guy that shoots things diagonally, I was thinking he would kind of look like a porcupine. These are all meant to be sort of like outdoorsy type enemies, except for that last guy who's kind of broke the rules, the guidelines. And the guy that patrols, I'm thinking he might actually be some sort of humanoid with a spear, but maybe not a humanoid. Humanoids, you know, typically would be more sentient, more smart. So it's just kind of silly to try and put a guy that just patrols and doesn't ever attack you. So yeah, this guy shouldn't really be a humanoid. This would be some sort of little benignish looking creature. Okay, let's do this guy that loops around and around stuff. Okay, but that's awesome. The Biag. Right? I think we can actually take this second one here and make this now an enemy. The Biag's a really simple, easy enemy to fight. All I do is bounce around. They're so much easier than the Jitters. The Jitters are really hard. So let's increase the difficulty of the Jitters. These guys should be like 0.5, maybe 0.3 minimum. And then the Biags, they should be... These are really easy enemies. So we're talking like 0 to 0.6, 0.5 maybe. Yeah. And we could do 4 to... It might be funny to do like 12 of them. Yeah, okay. And let's make sure that... Okay, if I take this to the quadruple A guy, we should still have these quadruple A guys on the screen. Yeah, okay, we got these guys. This was really cool to get these guys done last night. So the touching algorithm, you guys were both paying attention to that touching code I was writing yesterday and stuff, and the day before. But yeah, this is how it all turned out. It has to keep track of 8 different directions for what's near it, and then also 2 more directions for clockwise and counterclockwise. So we can do this whole walking around counterclockwise thing. But yeah, so the AI's almost done for him. But yeah, but let's just draw him now. So I'm thinking an anteater, right? He's like looking for crumbs or something, and that's what makes him walk around in a circle. Okay, so next one. The anteater guy. No worries, man. Hope it's interesting. Oh, and by the way, I posted to Gama Sutra. If anyone is looking to do their own Kickstarter, or I mean, just if you're your own game in general, check out this article. This is the cure for indie game failure. So, wanted to share that with you. This is basically a Kickstarter postmortem success story, but also how to prove that your game is worth your time. If you intend to make money with it. If you don't intend to make money with your video game, don't worry. You don't need to read this. This is for people that that need to make money. You know, this is how you make your living. This is what you should do before you go spend years at making your game. You should prove that it's worth it. All right, so next one. New. You were just reading it? Awesome, man. Ah, cool. So you're already aware of it. Nice. This might be enough right here. 24 by 32. Yeah, we'll see. Awesome, man. Cool. I hope it's good information, and I hope it connects with just the right people. You know, like that was such a hard lesson to learn. This failure, the flop. Your video game. You spent 2 years making it, or 4 years. Some people spend more longer than that. making their video game, and they, the whole time you have this hope in your mind. You're like, man, I hope I make money with this. And then it flops, dude. I want everyone to avoid that if possible. You know? Thanks, Silver Brit. Welcome to the stream, by the way. Is it working yet, Vlad? Okay, anteater enemy ho. Let's get a, okay, so I'm gonna draw a quick little blobby outline of him. So then we can see if he's right proportions. Always proportions first. Damn. I think Pedro's right. Bob Ross is the only priority for Twitch today. Okay, so what color is this guy? I'm thinking brownish, sort of a brownish, hairy looking. That's good, but way too saturated. Let's tone that down. Ooh, that's not saturated enough. There. How about there? Yeah, let's get, okay, blob time. Blob, blah, 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 blah. And then down to like some kind of like anteater type nose. Blah, 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 blah. This guy, oh man, I have a feeling I'm gonna like this guy. All right, cool. Okay, let's save him. What should we call him? Does anybody have any suggestions for what to name this guy? Feel free to shout out. I'm gonna wait like 30 seconds here so people can shout out if you have an idea for this guy's name. Let's give him a let's give him an eye. It works, yay! Celebration! Elephant? Fant? Teeter? Oh, such good names. But I like your first suggestion here, Elephant, and then that works really well with the second one. So let's just call him Fant. It's pretty simple. Yeah, Fant it is. Frozen Fire, Silverbit, TM, thank you. Okay, Fant it is. Let's call him Fant. All right, Fant and... Yeah, yeah! Yeah, isn't that great? You get to participate for real, man. Years to come, people are going to be looking back going, Frozen Fire named the Fant. Basically, Silverbit named him too. That's like a joint name right there. Okay, so yeah, let's start renaming his profile. That's going to be this one. This foes guy here is gonna be Fant. Let's do up to 8 of these for now. Maybe then we get a couple more in here. Ooh. Yeah.
It's gonna get dark in here, huh? Winter's coming.
Let's see if he's the right size, huh? Eh? Proportions? Yeah. Maybe. Alright, yeah. So the Fant profile. Wait, did I export that right? No, I haven't saved it or exported it yet. Oh, wait. We shouldn't export it with that gray background. At least like that. Fant, foes, Fant zero. It's Pikachu! All right. It's Clefairy. Does this have music? I'm definitely gonna watch this, but if it doesn't have music, I can watch it now. Are we ready to try it? Let's try it. Hope it works. Do we have a Pokemon yet? Come on. Yeah, we do. Nice. Oh man, these guys. Oh, they're just the right size. They're totally the right size. Okay. Oh man, I can't wait to animate them. So we're gonna need, you know, this is a north. These need north, south, east, and west directions. But we can get a cool little waddle going on. Oh yeah. Oh, this is gonna be great. I love these guys. Super great. Yeah, I hope not. It's not that I get banned, it's just that my videos can't be watched.
Who's that Pokemon?
It's Pikachu!
It's Clefairy!
Alright, well, I'll watch that again later. Alright, yeah, I'll start drawing this, make him look cool. Alright, so I'm happy with this start here. He needs to kind of waddle when he moves, but first of all, we'll just draw him how it'll actually be. So some shading to start with. His color is pretty good. Is it? Yeah, that's why I need to watch it later. Okay, I'm gonna do a palette. We got that color, let's get a darker color. And deeper. Maybe one more deeper. Maybe a little bit deeper in hue. Yeah, and this might be the lightest. I don't know. Yeah, maybe a little lighter and a lot less saturated for this sort of highlighty color. It's a little lighter. He's like hairy, right? He's hairy and stuff, so he's not going to get that much brighter in his highlights. Oh my god. You know how long it would take me to do that every day? Dude. Just opening a 2-hour video, right? So just opening the video file would take like 5 minutes, I'm sure. And then re-exporting and all that? That would be like a 3-hour task. Well, I'll save that kind of task for the professional YouTubers. I'm just an amateur YouTuber. So desaturate, right? Sort of, yeah, whitish almost now. Yeah, there, yeah. Oh yeah, oh yeah. Dude, that null pointer dereference was so funny, Pedro. The video you sent. There it is, you guys. You're dereferencing a null pointer. It'd be 3 hours well spent. But 3 hours of not game developing. Yeah, okay, we got a palette. Nice, we got a palette. All right, let's use this palette and draw this guy. The fan. Grubuck, what's up, man? Do I still have it? We don't have that link anymore. The null reference? Maybe it was somebody else shared it. You don't remember? Here it is. I found it. Bret Hart.
Right there in front of you the whole time. You're dereferencing a null pointer. Open your eyes. Come on, you guys. There it is, right there in front of you the whole time.
Yeah. Good idea. Yeah, little pops of color are really nice. Thank you, Silver Brit. Let's get a pink tongue-like color. No, that needs to be more red. It wasn't you. Dude, so awesome, right? I didn't know Bret Hart was a programmer. That's awesome. I never knew that. Good name for a game company. Tongue-like games. No. Wrong color for all that. Maybe you can have a nice highlight going on like that. Yeah, that's okay. No, he looks evil. Oh, damn. Now he's got like a crazy futuristic visor on. A white eye? You think a white eye? I don't know. White eyes are always more. Well, you know, sometimes white eyes do look evil. Let's try that out. Yes, nice, man. Glad it's back. Yeah, that actually does work. Bebop. All right, let's see if we're even on the right track with this. If all these colors even work in the game, you know? So let's save for web. Oh man, I'm so glad I fixed that problem with the texture packer. Yeah, I like him with the wide eye, and I can see that little tongue going in and out, and he'll look a lot better when we've got a north-south, and gotta get his feet moving. Yeah, that's it. Just get his feet moving next. Yeah! Curl and roll? I like that, but see, watch what he does. It's kind of cool that he would roll, but that would be a different kind of enemy behavior, right? This guy behaves, though his behavior, watch his behavior when he actually gets going for a minute. He's meant to walk around and around and around stuff. That's why I kind of wanted him to have a trunk or something like that. So it's like he's trying to look for something. Like, look at this guy right here. This guy right here. He walks around and around this one little pillar. That's all. That's the entire behavior of this AI. Very simple, very dumb AI. So I like the idea of an enemy that rolls into a ball, but that would be better suited for something else, like a guy that bounces around the screen, you know, or something. So good. It's a good suggestion nonetheless. Yeah. Man. 1990, I was 10 years old. Okay, all right, so let's get him walking. This could be frame one here. Let's turn off propagate frame one before Photoshop propagates frame one all over the place. Freaking propagate frame one. Scourge of my existence. Okay, I can see his leg kind of coming forward like this. Yeah. Yeah, but it's meant to be a raven, a large bird like that. Yeah. Yeah, he's meant to have hair already. This is kind of meant to be look like hair. But I just didn't do any texturing. So yeah, that's a good point. I should probably texture this before I do that. This next animation. Alright. We'll see what this will look like textured. Hairy. More hairy. I didn't know they were that hairy. That's awesome. Yeah, this is a different planet, so it's not like this is really has to be perfect, you know. So let's give him some hairy lines. He's, if we get some lines going on. Yeah, like this. And we'll make sure that that doesn't look weird in the game. I know. Don't have enough pixels for many things. But that's part of the art. Yeah, I guess that looks okay. Yeah, that does look hairier. Okay, fine. So it's going to be pretty simple to make him walk. That leg moves forward. Yeah, so he's going to have a frame where this leg moves, his back leg moves back and his front leg moves forward. This is the back forward one. And this is the middle. And then this is this next one. We'll make another one. Wait, this one should be duplicated off of that. All right, so this one is where they both come together. And, okay, and his snout should move a little bit, too. Oh, yeah, yeah. Yeah, the previous monster guy. All right. Foes. The Biag. Keep in mind, these are very simple enemies. They're not meant to be very smart. Right. I am going to fix these guys a little bit so they reflect instead of just go in the opposite direction when they hit stuff. Okay, let's do something fun though. Let's make 99 of those guys. What's gonna happen? Whoa! Oh, we need the fire sword for this. Fire sword! I can't wait to put so many mobs in the game like this. The Jib's busy. He's like, oh, I gotta scan everything. Chaos! Chaos! You get the point. That was fun. K Can't wait to add that kind of stuff to the game. There's definitely going to be a lot of dungeons where there's that kind of stuff. Yucky ooze? That's a good idea. Let's try it right now. We'll add some yucky ooze. Then we'll get back to the Fant guy. Okay, but if we want to see this, we actually have to turn that down to like 9 instead of 99. Yeah, the fire effect does work diagonally, but I noticed that the sword didn't work that well diagonally. You saw that? Did you see that diagonal sword? It didn't look right. So I probably need to make the swords so they can only fire in 4 compass directions. Dang. There we go, we got some ooze. Uh-huh. Okay. Oh, you know what? That should be only 0.1. Ooh, might have to refresh this animation here. Raw sheets. Foes. Biag release star. Ping. There. Okay, let's try that again. Export, render. Oh, I was saying the fireworks well, but the sword itself didn't look well diagonal. Not the fire, but this, or maybe I just need to draw another sword then. That's actually a good idea. Yeah, exactly. Rotate the bolt. Yeah, good idea. Okay, it's decided. I'll rotate the bolt for diagonal directions. Because, yeah, people are going to want that. The swords are just rad items. Okay, let's see if that looks good. Maybe. But I've always had black blood and everything, or black ooze coming out of everything, because these have nanites inside their blood or oil or whatever it is. So I don't know what other color I could really use besides black, but. Well, you couldn't really see it come out. Yeah, I guess if it was green or something, maybe it would work. All right, man. See ya. Bye, Pedro. Yeah, hopefully. I can try some other. Oh. Well, that's why it didn't look right, because it didn't. I didn't animate it. Duh. It should be that frame. There. Yeah, that does look cool. I like it. I'll keep it like that. Alright, so let's get back to this other guy. Alright, so each one of these frames, I want his pink little tongue to disappear. And, okay, in this first frame, his right foot goes forward, his left foot goes back, and so he would wiggle his body a little bit to the side, right? So you're gonna see his eye is gonna move forward, and his whole head is going to very slightly darken. Let's do a very slight darkening with pure black. No, I'm not going to leave it like that. I'm just going to do that, apply it to the frame, and then make it really, really. All right, that's 0. Yeah, very subtle. 15% max. 10 is good. There we go. Okay. Right, just very slight. Makes it turn a little bit. Maybe actually. Yeah, that works too. There. Okay. And then merge these. Yeah, narrow his head? Yeah, let's think. Okay, if he goes a little to the side, yeah, maybe his trunk would narrow. Or, oh, yeah, it would at least squish in a little bit. Yeah. Yeah, that looks pretty good. But move this highlight. Maybe take away the highlight. Yeah. Maybe like that. Yeah. Good call. Okay, and then this last frame where his body is the other way, he's gonna lighten a little bit. Same thing with his trunk. I think his eye can probably stay in the same, or maybe move back actually. Yeah, let's try with him moving back a little bit. And then let's try lightening it a little bit. It would be like a white color. Well, that's way too much. Even that's a bit too much. Maybe soft light or something. Let's try. What the? Yeah, there it is. Shift plus. I'm trying to find the right. There. Something that looks good. Hard light? No. These are all kind of weird. I don't know if I need to do this. Normal. It's the same thing, really. That's 1%. Yeah, no, that just looks wrong. Screw it. Let's not even do that. Okay. Okay, let's see what that looks like animated. This is going to be the first frame here. I almost think he should like maybe hunches back a little bit when he gets to one of these middle frames. Like his back moves up a little bit. Just a pixel. Let's see what that would look like. Maybe that frame where he's turned to the side or something. Yeah, it does work, right? It works. It works already, but maybe it can be a tiny bit better. We'll see, right? Let's try moving his back just one pixel up for one of these frames. Just like that part of his body there. Whoa, that's a lot. I don't know if this is gonna work. Let's see though. No. That one pixel is one too many. Okay, and next thing, one last thing. This will help it. I think if his pink tongue should be on the middle frames, not the first frame. So this first frame, no. This frame, yes. What the hell? Mode behind? How did I get that? There. There. He definitely looks like he's going for something. He's trying to get that stuff. Oh, the little crack in his body should be a little bit different. So when he gets there, this crack should widen a little bit, even just a pixel like that. And then this one should disappear almost. Yeah, and the hair on his body on this frame. Needs to move. Maybe one of these frames, his tail should flick up or something too. Yeah, like that frame. I like that. What's up, Chunk of Beer? What's up, man? How you doing today? Right. Let's export. This is going to be the east. Okay, I got to resave this. It should be Fant East. Ah, not again. Bob Ross. Oh, wait, these should all be 0.1. Nice, man. Right on. Okay, now let's change this animation for this guy. Yes. I didn't notice this, but yeah. Okay, so Pedro did this one earlier, but it. Thank you, Bob Ross. Thanks for making and sharing all your art over the years. All right, let's see how he looks. Oh, wait. These should have a delay. Oh, yeah, this one should have, this should be just E0. This one should be those frames. And this should be a delay of 0.2. There. Okay, we'll see how he looks east, and then we'll get him walking north-south, too. Maybe two more animations for that, but really simple animations. Oh, got to change back to the other guys. Fan. Why'd you walk in? Oh, because I didn't give him a walk yet. It said the release. That's the wrong animation. This is going to be run. Run? Yeah, I think it's just run. Oh, I love seeing his tongue, but maybe you see his tongue a little bit too much. Yeah, it's a little bit too much tongue. Too much tongue. Yeah, let's take it off. Maybe this frame here doesn't need it. I love these guys. They're so lovable. I'm sorry to kill you even. Just leave you alone. All right, yeah, so we need a death animation, we need a north animation, we need a south animation. I love him. Yeah, sweet, right? Okay, what next? Walk north, walk south. How much do I have left on today's stream, by the way? A little bit. We got 20 minutes left. That's enough time to do this, I think. Let's do this. So this is going to be north, south. Let's do south first. North is really easy. It's just his butt the whole time. You know, there's very little character going on. Looking at somebody's butt. Wait. Sorry, I need to qualify that statement. Fant east, fant north, south. Should we do north? Yeah, let's do south. South first, and then north is just easy. Okay, so we'll start with the first frame. Butt hype. Hype it for the butt. The easy butt. Hmm. So, like, how wide it would be he be? A little less wide than he is right now. From this distance here. So his width is going to be like maybe 9 or 8. Probably 8 pixels. Yeah, let's do 8 pixels wide. He's only going to be that wide. No, that's a little, that's maybe a little too skinny. But if I add back on this pixel over here, it'll help. Yeah, no, that's, that feels too skinny to me. Something like that. Yeah. That gives him more of a furry feeling. Then 13. Oh, he's off there. And now there's balance, but not on like his trunk yet. His trunk's not right. His eyes might even be too narrow. Huh. Now he looks really weird. Oh, what to do? This is why pixel art is a challenge sometimes. Yeah, I guess that's right. Okay, we can at least do these highlights like about like this. Right? We need like a, maybe just a lighter color, but not quite that light. Yeah. Yeah, TM. Yeah, wider trunk, maybe. Yeah. Let's see. Oh, yeah, that helped already. Just those 2 pixels right there. But now that's worse there. Okay, I think a different color for his trunk would help. All right. A little less saturation. Oh, and a shadow at the bottom would help too. Maybe not that much shadow though. Man, he looks weird. Maybe, okay, maybe it's some lines going down. Different color around the eyes, yeah? Oh yeah, maybe make him look a little sunken almost. That helped a little. I'm thinking in the trunk part, if there were some lines, like... Like Alf? He does kind of look like Alf, doesn't he? The world today, you can't type Alf. Alf! Dude, I love Alf. Let's try a little darker then. Yeah, that works. That's cool. I like that. One last change here, this top bit of pixels there. This. Right, now he's kind of got a little, yeah, that looks a little better. Okay. That gets pretty good for now. Now let's animate him. He does look kind of funny, like he's like almost like a trash can or something, but what are you gonna do? Oh, that kind of helps. A little bit of like shading going on here. That helps too. Filling in those two pixels there. Ah, there we go. That was nice. What a difference one pixel makes. Yeah, definitely swinging. Yeah. Swinging the trunk is going to make him look way lively. He's going to be a lot more lively than he does right now. He's like a little blob almost right now, but he'll look better for sure. Okay, so first frame to the left. Let's do to the right or left. Doesn't matter, really. I'm actually thinking his trunk should move and not be so Like maybe you should go one more pixel to the right there. Oh, now it's kind of looking weird. Maybe. Yeah, okay, let's try a quick animation where he's let's see if this works. So we'll just duplicate that. Oh, let's duplicate this first frame. And we need that pink tongue. Okay. Let's see how this is looking. Ah, his eyes look so weird. Oh, gotta fix that. Okay, yeah, so when he turns, his eyes definitely shouldn't do that. All right, let's get both the eyes to move then. All right, yeah. Next thing, it would really help as he's moving his body to give his actual body some more shading. So, right here, this half of his body is getting further away. So, this is where he needs more shading in his body. Maybe even some less pixels. Man, I don't know. Right? Let's try those less pixels at first. And then the same thing on this side. Let's take away those two pixels. And maybe even increase the highlight a little bit on this side. No, yeah, he definitely should keep his pixels. So, but make them darker. Let's try that and this. And I like how this other frame had that going on. Yeah. Only it's a little darker shading on the sides that are further away. Alright, I think that's worth trying out. Let's see it in the game. Yeah. Just make it look as good as you can, I guess. I'm not really a professionally trained artist or anything. I'm just doing what I can. So, we'll save that. Render. Ugh. Tired today. Foes. Should work. Now I'll give him a south facing run. Oh wait, did I miss? Oh, I did it right. Nice. Okay, so there's gonna be no north animation, but at least there'll be a south animation. Oh, the blank pixel, did I mess it up? Oh man, this guy's so funny. But yeah, we need a north animation now. Okay, let me see that blank pixel you're talking about. Right? Oh yeah, good point. Yeah, that would definitely add a little bit of weirdness there, so let's fix that up. Good call. Thanks, Chuck a Beer. Yeah, right. And then now we got the north animation. It's going to be so easy for the north. Okay, so we'll export this again. And then we'll save it as the north. And it should be really easy. Hope you're hyped for the butt, because we're doing the butt now. Yeah, he's turning out all right, huh? Okay, so we'll save this as... Fan North. We'll get that other one open too, in case we need it again. But hi. All right, TM. Good night, man. All right, is that a good butt, huh? For a start? Is there anything else that needs to change on this butt? First of all, his shading needs to look more like hair. That's kind of bad shading. Bad texturing, I mean. There, now it looks more like hair. Other than that, I kind of like this little nut-like thing right here. His tail looks good. Yeah, and that'll be a nice thing to characterize him here. Okay. Let's get another frame. So the second frame is where he moves his butt to the right. Right butt. Yeah, totally. And this is gonna happen. Right, his texturing is gonna move a little bit as he moves as well. There we go. All right. Do the next one. Same thing with his all of his shading. Okay. All right, let's see that in action. All right, so he needs the same thing going on the top of his body, right? The bottom looks pretty good, his butt's looking good, but the top of his body also needs to change its shading to give you that feeling that he's moving his whole body. So like with his tail to the left here, this bit of his, he shouldn't have any highlights here. And in fact, this should darken a little bit. Maybe a highlight there, though. No, actually, maybe just regular color there. Yeah, that's good. Okay, and then same thing on this side. His butt's to the right, so the right side is going to darken. Maybe a little too much. Yeah, a little bit too much highlight and shading going on here. That there and this. Still too much on the top. There's too much shading on the top. Yeah, that's about right, I guess. This looks weird when it's this one frame here, when he's got, it's just too much, still too much shading here. Yeah, it's starting to look good, right? Yeah, that'll work. Okay. Oh, but that one pixel is moving. That's better. Okay, let's try this out. And this might be about the end of the stream. I'm at about 2 hours right now, but this is great. I mean, I've never really drawn two whole enemies in one stream before. These are very simple little enemies. But yes, I love seeing them walk north and south. Dude, these are such great little enemies. Oh, yeah. Oh, I don't know how I'm going to make them die, though. How are they going to actually... You want to kill them? Maybe they should be invincible. I guess I should do some kind of death animation for them. Yeah, very satisfied with today's results, so... Right? You think so? Chocolate beer? Nice, man. Alright, so yeah, that's it for today's stream. I worked on two new enemies today. This guy is called the Fant. It's a little elephant anteater-looking thing. He just walks him around and around stuff. He's a real stupid little enemy. There's another guy, too. How dare you, right? Maybe they should be just invincible. I don't know. Play around with that. So what I'm gonna do later is I'll decide what should be, you know, if these guys should be invincible or whether they should have a dying animation. And then I got two more enemies too. I've got the behaviors done for, and I'll be working on them too. So I'm not sure what I'll be doing tomorrow, but I'll be back around 2 to 4 p.m. Pacific time. And if you're interested in this game, if you don't know what you're looking at, this game's called Songbringer. And it's coming out in 2016. So, cheers, you guys. We'll see you next time.